Still Alice by Lisa Genova. The book is a fictional story of a 50-year-old woman's descent into dementia through early onset Alzheimer's disease. Alice is a professor with tenure at Harvard University when the symptoms of the Alzheimer's disease first appear. She attributes it to her busy life, menopausal age, and so on, but things get worse and she eventually consulted a neurologist. Then she lost her ability to rely on her own thoughts and also lost her intellectual title at Harvard. She is starting to question her identity and her existence with the disease worsening, but she still lives surrounded with family, even when she don't remember them. Short background of the author. Well, she's a Harvard postgraduate and a neuroscientist, so that is why the setting of the book is in that super famous university. And she had the access also to many topics related to the disease of the character. This book is self-published in the years 2007 and 2009. My personal opinion of the book would be simple. It is well-researched and almost sounded academical for a fiction novel. Maybe I'm not fascinated with memory issues in any story, but that is why I was not that hooked. Yes, I had read, watched, or listened to stories about amnesia, Alzheimer's, and I don't find any affection for it. It seems unreal to me. I know that in the real world, it doesn't seem that way. People forget. Nothing is permanent. And I don't think that people exist to be remembered. I know that it is awful to be forgotten, especially with someone you love. But would you rather be the one to forget or the one forgotten? It hurts more if you are the only one who remembers, because suffering is in remembering. It's in the head. While the other person, I don't know, maybe it's hard for him or her, but if the people won't remind a person with Alzheimer's or amnesia of what he or she needs to remember, I don't think that matters at all to him or her personally. It's tricky to talk about Alzheimer's disease. Very few people know about it. They think it's an illness that occurs to people past the age of 80. But you or me could have an early onset with this disease. That is, I think, the core message of the story, to be more aware of the illness. I think in a way or another, we know one or two people that have dementia. Our old neighbor, maybe grandparents, or someone in our family. I have one in my family, my uncle. He is 85 years old now, I think, and he has dementia. He doesn't know me. Well, I'm not that close to him, and we see each other rarely, and so I really don't think that matters. The thing is, he keeps on repeating himself during conversations. It's cute, actually. He recognized my older sister because he had lived with his family for quite some time. And my uncle directs most of his questions to her, to my sister, when we visited. The amazing thing is he still can read and had a good eyesight. He reads the paper every day and talks about the past, but recent happening seems to be easily forgotten. It happened to him, and it had happened also to his father, my grandfather, and it could happen to me. This disease runs in families, so you might want to ask your parents now if their grandparents had memory problems. The problem is, even if you have traced the disease in your family, there is no cure for it. There are medications, but they only slow the disease progress. They may make our remaining neurons healthy, but they can't resurrect the dead neurons, sadly. Let's just be positive that, you know, soon in time, there will be new studies to make us remember. But what if you just want to forget everything, though? It would be blissful to forget some parts of our life, right? To forget the stories that we brought to our head and had caused us to suffer. Yes, that would be great, to have a selective memory. The story of Alice is a great reminder how impermanent things are. Our positions in life, as a mother, as a professor, as a wife, they all can be taken away in our thoughts. People may remember us in the titles that we had played, but at the end of the day, it could all be forgotten when suddenly our neurons make a decision that they don't want to work in the way that they used to be. People with Alzheimer's can keep going. They have to live their life, like in the story. There is no cure, not yet. Let's be patient with them. Allow them more time to do their activities of daily living. If any of our family members would have that kind of illness, God forbid, you know. There are many organizations, by the way, that could help these people and caregivers. And I believe that it is all available in the internet. This book is not just about Alice. It is the story of the family. Because truly in any disease process, it always involves the family. The family goes through and grows through with it. If there is no family, well, I hope not, because it's going to be more tragic. There is a movie of this book, Still Alice, if I am not mistaken. So you can check that out if reading is not your thing. I believe that the title is Still Alice. Thank you for listening.